Hi there, my name's Mark Shepard. We're at New Forest Farm in Southwest Wisconsin. For the past 23 years, we've been converting a typical corn and beans row crops farm into a perennial polyculture agroforestry system that mimics the oak savanna plant community type. Our primary cash flow has been produce, nursery stock, especially chestnuts and hazels. My edible woody crops nursery, Forest Agriculture Enterprises, has been selling chestnut, hazelnut, pine nut, apples, a whole number of different edible crops, and we're doing the breeding right here on the farm. We also raise grass-fed livestock, beef and pork. Part of where we're standing right now is in an alley cropping system. Our first job on the farm was to install a water management system. What we did is way up at the valley, up this alley, that way, there's a small pond. When that fills full of rainwater in a storm, we have channels that are excavated to bring it out to the ridge. All of the water that would have gone to this valley now hits these channels and spreads to the ridge. But you can see here by the shape of this alley that the water would flow from way up in the head of the valley, slightly downhill. In this case, we're using a 1% slope. That means it drops 1 foot over every 100 foot that it moves forward. So it comes out this way to the ridge. That valley form brings the water this way. Once it hits the ridge, it hits this big level spot that's a slight depression, and there's a rim here, and it becomes a big shallow pond, and it sheets over the edge of the pond up on the ridge. So formerly, the valleys were the wettest spots on the farm. Now, the ridges have wet spots on them, which is fine by me because I know this water is soaking in deep. And who's benefiting from the water being soaked in deep are all of the chestnut trees up on this ridge, for example. The asparagus gets it as well. And of course, everything is alley cropped. This happens to be alley cropped with chestnuts. Hybrid chestnuts, they're Chinese-European crosses. The Chinese chestnuts have typically not been cold hardy enough here in Southwest Wisconsin. As I keep bringing more genetics onto the site, it seems that my hybrids are appearing to be more and more Chinese. My original thought is we would take the cold hardiness of the American chestnut and the blight resistance of the Chinese chestnut. When we cross them, we'll have a cold hardy blight resistant. The ones that die from the blight, we know they're not resistant, and that's okay, let them die. Then the ones that freeze to the ground, we know that they're not cold hardy, and that's fine. The survivors that we've treated with strategic total utter neglect, stun, the survivors are the ones that are suited for this site. And then of course we select for the ones that reproduce really young in their lives, and then the ones that produce the heaviest crops. So this is alley cropping with an annual crop. If you'd like to see alley cropping with a perennial crop, we can walk right over here this way. All right, here we are in one of the alleys where we're growing asparagus as the cash crop in the alley. We have four such alleys. Chestnut is on either side. Approximately 2 acres of asparagus, so that's 2 football fields worth of asparagus. What's interesting about the asparagus, because of the competitive effects, we grow it in a heavy sod just like the asparagus you see in the ditch on the side of the road, and it's growing in competition with the chestnut trees right nearby. We probably get about half the yields that you could expect out of a clean tilled asparagus crop, but that's not my goals. My goals are to have an easy system to manage that is profitable by itself. So once you plant the asparagus, take minimal care of it. I mow it a few times in the springtime, scalp mow it right to the ground, and then the asparagus itself emerges through the weeds, which are mostly grasses. We see some, you know, various different ragweeds and stuff like that. It's a 22-year-old patch now, 23 years old. Meanwhile though, as the asparagus has peaked in production, the chestnuts have started to increase in production. And now as the asparagus starts to decline, the chestnut yields are increasing even more. And I don't know if we're going to do the asparagus for another 2 years, 5 years, 10 years, mow it and have it all be pasture and graze cattle in here. I've got options. When you're doing an alley cropping system, you end up with options. The hazelnuts that we're growing here at New Forest Farm are all hybrid, which means that they're different species mixed together. We've got European American, we have beaked, which is also a Native American type. The two plants have dramatically different growth characteristics. The American hazel is a rounded shrub form. Both European and American are multi-stem. The American hazel classically has a husk around the nut that encloses the whole nut. on the more American type hybrid hazels that are being grown in upper Midwest, the idea is to grow them high density within the row, approaching 1,000 stems per acre, and then have them grown as hedgerows and have them be harvested over the top with a straddle harvester. Currently right now, the Americans are really easy to harvest by hand because the plant doesn't really get much taller than 8 or 10 foot tall. The stems are really flexible and they don't break. You just bend them down to the ground, you strip the nuts off. They get dried down and then they have to be husked. The husk has to be removed mechanically. We use a modified version of the insides of a combine to do that. So these are hazelnuts that we in the northern climates that get 20 below, 40 below, we can grow, and we can grow them either like European small trees, or we can grow the American type with the enclosed husk and either harvest them by hand or over the top with a straddle harvester. So we're in the some of the oldest chestnut trees on New Forest Farm in Southwest Wisconsin. And this is an area that we use exclusively as a silvopasture system, most specifically for pigs. They get a mixed feed ration, organic feed ration, mostly for the vitamin part of it, the minerals, so they get a good balanced mineral. I only feed them enough to feed a little 30 pound pig. So if they want to eat more and if they're hungry, they have to go out and graze more. They clean it completely out. So whatever's in season, starting with currants in the spring, raspberries, underneath the currants, they'll get rid of all of the weeds underneath the currants and they'll eat the berries right off the bush. Then they'll kind of move to the raspberries. Then they move to the mulberries. This time of year, they're kind of between. They just went through mulberries and cherries. They're just finishing up cherries. There's still some mulberries on the trees. They've started tearing into the grapes. They'll pull the vines right off of the trees. I let the grapes climb low on the trees. I don't let them climb all the way up high. I pull the vines down if the pigs don't. The pigs will pull the vines down, eat all the leaves off the vine. They'll eat the fruit. They'll be crunching on big bunches of green grapes. They'll go up to elderberries as the elderberries start to get ripe, and they'll eat the elderberries right off the tree. They'll get up to full body size by mid-September when the chestnuts start to ripen, and then they just fatten up because the chestnut is it's a high carbohydrate. It's a lot like eating corn, and they just gorge on chestnuts and they turn into nice chestnut fattened hogs. And the last month of their life, I'll feed them their morning snack and their evening snack on the livestock trailer. So when the day comes to go to the slaughterhouse, I just go up to the trailer and shut the door. No stress of forcing them down a squeeze chute or using cattle prods to get them to load a trailer. They just do it all by themselves. We named every single one of them. They're all identifiable. They all get patted every single day. They get treated really well. We care for them as pets. I don't ever want this to be a callous, heartless thing. I think that's part of our humanity, is the fact that we do identify with these animals. These are our friends and they will become us. I'm gonna have pork chops tonight, I really am. I know that they've lived a good, healthy, happy life and they only have one bad day.
Let's go, here we go. Yes. Little pig, 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 pig. Oh, yes. What a good boy, Henry. What a good boy, Henry.